and then frequencies, and then go ahead and move gender and ethnicity over. And then the default for statistics, there are none here. And for now, we'll just leave it as is. We'll just go ahead and get display frequency tables. So click OK. And then we have our output window that opens. And we can see here that we have one male, two females, for a total of three. And it says missing system two, and I'll show you about that in a minute. And then for ethnicity, we have one Caucasian, one Hispanic, one other, and we see this missing two again. This means that we don't have, for some reason, two of our ethnicities are not reported. Let's try and figure out what was going on there. So I'll go back to my data editor window. Well, if you recall, a minute ago I entered 004, 005, right? And I said, let's go ahead and delete those. Well, if you notice here, it's kind of hard to see, but there's little periods here. When I deleted these values, SPSS still kept these two rows active in a sense. Notice that 4 and 5 here are in boldface type, whereas these are grayed out. So SPSS is treating these as if we have two observations here, and they're just calling those missing. Now, we can get rid of that very easily. If we just select and drag on these two rows, on the row headings here, which is what these are called, right click, select clear. Now notice the periods are gone. Let's go back and rerun our frequencies. So analyze descriptive statistics frequencies, and then just click OK. And then now notice, do you see the missing anymore? It's not there, right? That removed it, and that was the reason why it was there in the first place, because we entered those ID numbers, deleted them, but the rows were still active from the perspective of SPSS. So it interpreted those two rows as missing. But now that's gone. And notice here one other thing. We have male and female, not one and two. That's another benefit of creating these value labels here. Behind the scenes, SPSS displays or knows that a one is male and two is female. So when we run our analysis, instead of having a 1 here, we have male. Instead of 2, we have female. And the same thing with ethnicity. And that really helps when you're interpreting your results, especially if you go back to the data after some time. It's easy to forget who was a 1 and who was a 2, for example. So by coding males 1, females 2, we always have that memory in our data file. So we don't have to try and go back and figure out who was who. Okay, one last analysis. Go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and then this time choose Descriptives. Let's go ahead and move Age and all the Satisfaction with Life variables over. And if you're curious, I grabbed all of those by clicking on Age, pressing and holding the Shift key, and then clicking on the last value, and that grabs them all at once. That's kind of nice. It saves us a little bit of time. So then move that over, click on Options. We get the mean or the arithmetic average, standard deviation, minimum, and maximum by default. We'll go ahead and leave those on. That's fine. So click continue and then OK. And then here we can see the mean for age. We have a mean age of 26 with a minimum of 21 and a maximum of 32. And then we see our satisfaction with life values. The smallest was 3 for 1, 2, and 3. And a 4 for 4 and 5, and the largest was 7 for all of them. And then you can see the means here as well and the standard deviations. All right, so that's about it for entering, creating a data file from questionnaire or survey data in SPSS. Thanks for watching.